following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
Welcome to Sesame Street. Glad you are here. I'm going to check out these three boxes. This is where I keep my musical instruments. And I'm going to check each box to see how many I have in there. Harmonicas. 1, 2, 3 harmonicas. Here I keep my toy trumpets. 1, 2, 3 toy trumpets. And here I keep my toy flutes. Oh, just one. One toy flute. Well, I guess I have to order some toy flutes. You know, Gordon bought one of these flutes for a friend of his.
There he is. There he is, a Cotamundi. That's not a stupid Cotamundi. That's one of the smartest Cotamundis you ever saw. You know why he's smart?
No.
Because he's alive.
I know.
Okay, go ahead, tell me.
He has a short nose.
No, he's got a long nose. Look at that nose. He uses that nose to grub around for worms and things. You know that?
Worms.
Sure.
He's an ant eater.
He makes worm sandwiches.
Oh,
wow. Oh,
you're
does.
Kidding.
No, and you scared him, too, when you knocked on that glass. He didn't know what was happening. And you see those sharp claws he has?
Nope.
You don't?
No.
Look at his feet. There you are. One. Oh, boy. Look at that long tail.
It looks like a leopard.
A leopard?
Tail.
No, that tail looks like a raccoon's tail. Because that's what he's related to.
I know
to.
What.
Yes, yeah, Cedric?
He's two parts.
He's two parts?
Raccoon tail. Ant-eater nose.
Raccoon tail, ant-eater nose, and what else? And Cotamundi body, right? Okay, got him into three parts. But he travels in packs of like 30 Cotamundis coming up all at once. Can you imagine that?
No.
You're walking down the street, Lance, and then all of a sudden you look down and 30 Cotamundis are coming up.
I'll be going.
They live in South America. And in Arizona, come up as far north as Arizona. It's a swinging Cotamundi.
Swinging?
Not swimming.
Swings.
He might be able to swim,
Why
I don't know.
Why can't he climb up the glass?
Why can't he climb up the glass? He might be able to, but right now I don't think he's going to.
He's afraid, he's shivering.
No, he's not shivering. He's looking at you, you know that?
He's looking at you.
He's looking at me.
He's looking at me.
Looking at everybody.
Why doesn't he eat the apple?
Well, because he's off apples right now. He had some apples before he came here. He'll get some more apples later on.
Who
apples,
brought him
pears,
here?
Nectarines, huh?
Who brought him here?
Who brought him here? I did. I was down in South America. Hey, you want to look at another animal?
Yeah.
Okay, how about looking at a baby reindeer? Okay.
It's right over there.
But you will in a minute. There it is.
Oh, there it is.
You see the baby reindeer?
Yeah.
Look at that. Well, how about that? And there's his mother.
He's trying to walk.
Yeah, and he fell down. Well, that's one bad try. You think you'll try it again?
Yeah.
You don't think so, Sumiko? Well, maybe just might stay there forever. I don't know, maybe. Aha, look at that. Look, there he is. Just got up. Now, what is a baby reindeer going to do now?
He's getting a drink of milk?
Reindeer milk?
Wait.
Pasteurized reindeer milk. Look at him, he's trying to get a drink. You're right. You know, the mother is slick. You know what the mother's doing?
Trying to make him
walk. Ray knows good and well that the baby reindeer wants some milk, see? And the mother knows where the milk is. So when the mother moves away with the milk, baby reindeer clippity-clops right after it. Having a lot of trouble walking.
Kicking him in the face.
No, it's not kicking him in the face, Lance. Look at that. There he goes, just as wobbly as he can be. You think he'll stand up?
Yep.
Rasputin reindeer, look at him. Oh, he's got a drink, Good. How about that? Yes, good drink too. Loves that reindeer milk.
Where does he get the drink from?
From the mother.
No.
No, what?
Where does it come out?
In the mother's udder. It's an udder mother.
It's an udder mother.
Look, Big Bird was kind enough to write all the numbers down so we can practice. Uh-oh. He left something out. What did he leave out, gang?
Three.
Yeah, look. Here's the way Big Bird has his numbers. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Cedric, where does the 3 belong?
Between the 2 and the 4.
The 2 and the 4, so how should it be?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Now, did you know what a 3 looked like?
You want one? Here you are. Here. Jelly. Ooh, what do I hear?
Skyrider.
You hear? What?
Skyrider. What?
You want a jelly bean?
Yeah.
Is that Skyrider here? Let's look up. Oh! Look at it. What's he up to today? Uh-oh. What's he making?
Was he an A?
An L. An L. A straight line. Looks like an L, right?
How about a V? A W?
Wait a minute. You're rushing.
A P.
Maybe. Uh-oh. Yes.
That's it.
Looks like a... Yes, that... Oh, it's a... He's still going. He's still going. Wait. Maybe a B. Right. Okay, so up there. Oh, he really can go up there, isn't he, huh? Wow, look at that airplane up there. Wow. Up by the airplane. Up. There he goes. Wow. Well, you know, I'm thinking of a word that begins with the letter R. You turn it on, and you listen.
A radio!
Oh, boy. Oh, I just don't know how to do it. Hi. You know what I'm trying to do? Well, I have my easel set up with a drawing pad, and I was going to draw some letters. I thought I'd work on R's today, but I can't remember how to make a little R. Now, how does that go? I wish there was someone around to help me, but no one's here right now. And what? Look! A little R! Hey, come here, little R. Come here. He'll be afraid. Hey, little R. You're very cute. You're about the cutest little R I've ever seen. Oh, he kissed me. Hey, he kissed me. You, why, you are going to be my friend, aren't you? Yes. Oh, we're going to be pals forever. By golly, I'm going to feed you, and I'll teach you how to do tricks, and we'll... That's it, tricks. Little R, jump up here on my beak. Hey, that was very good. Hey, Little R, let's see if you can do something else, like, roll over. Let's see, roll over. Oh, he did it. He does what I tell him. Hey, oh. Oh, you're getting me dizzy going around and around. Whoa, and you'll be dizzy too. Say, Little R, you are so terrific. May I draw your picture? Okay, you hold still. This is the help I needed. Let me see, an R. You got a vertical line. Vertical means up and down, like this. Gordon taught me that word. And then you have a little curved line. Like that. And that's a little R, just like you, little R. Hey, little R, isn't that good? Boy, wait till I show everybody my new friend, a little R. Boy, oh boy. And I can even draw a good picture. Oh, there you are! Gordon! Mr. Rooper!
Hooper.
Oh, Mr. Hooper. And Gordon, I have a new friend. He's a little R. He came floating down, and I made friends with him, and I taught him how to do tricks and roll over and sit on my beak. He's terrific.
An R?
Yeah.
Sits on your head and rolls over?
Mm-hmm.
Big Bird, that's so funny. It isn't even simple.
But no. He come right here. Now, come here. Look. Now, here he is. Wait a minute. He's gone. Where did he go? He was here.
Yeah, Big Bird, that's a nice little R you drew there, you know. But I think your imagination's kind of run away with
it. Oh, no. He was here. He really was. He was right here, and I did all those things with
him.
Yeah,
well, Big Bird, if he comes back, call us. You know, we'll be down the store.
You don't believe me, do you?
Not bad, yeah.
Would you like some water?
No, I feel fine, but he was here.
I have some bird seed down
no,
there.
No,
sort of treat it
no,
for
that's
cases
not
like
necessary.
This.
Never mind.
Let's go down the store.
They don't believe me. But you believe me, don't you? You saw him. He was right here. I've got to find him so I can show them the little R. Little R, where are you? Come out, wherever you are. Little R, where are... Oh, there you are. You're back. Oh, I'm so glad to see you again. Don't run away again, please, Little R, because... A big R. Oh, he gave him a little kiss. I'll bet that big R is your big brother, is he? I'll bet you you were lost, and he came along and found you. Is that right? Aha! Oh, Lil R, you must be happy now. Big R, I'm glad you came along and found your little brother. Say, now that you're here, can I use you as a model so I can draw your picture too? Okay. Let's see. You're like the little R, except you're a lot bigger. So you go up like this. A long, tall line. And let's see. Oh, you've got a curve like a backward C. Like that. Oh, that looks like a P. Well, you don't look much like your little brother. And there's a line down there. There. That's a big R and a little R. Hey, thank you, Big R. And Little R, thank you. And I'm glad that you found your big brother. Bye. Oh, there goes a couple of nice little R's.
I'm in a big R and little R.
Hiya, Big Bird.
Oh, hi, Mr. Pooper and Gordon.
Any more bouncing R's pass your way?
Yes, indeed, there were. A big R came this time, and he found his little brother, the little R, and they're happy now. The little R isn't lost anymore, you see.
Big Bird, listen, I've been on the street a long time, and I've seen jump ropes and basketballs and scooters and everything, but I'm here to tell you that there are no such things as bouncing R's on Sesame Street.
There aren't?
No.
No, there aren't. There are no lost baby R's that sit on your head and roll over.
No.
And big brother R's who come and find them.
No.
Well, if there aren't, what do you call these?
Ah, you know what? Time to play One of These Things Is Not Like the Others. So you sing along with me until you find this song. One of these things is not like the others. One of these things doesn't belong. Can you tell which thing is not like the others by the time I finish my song? Okay, look at the board carefully now. Look at each one and figure out which one is not like the others. Well, did you guess which thing is not like the others? Did you guess which thing doesn't belong? If you guess this thing is not like the others, then you're absolutely right. Okay, now, first of all, these are all letters, and they're all the same letter. They're the letter R. Now, these three are the same, and this one is not like the others because these three are the little or small R, and this is the capital R. R's a nice letter, isn't it?
You see, it's very interesting about the crows. See the blue in the crow's eye? Huh? Yeah. The lovely beak. You know some people train a crow?
Yeah.
Yeah. You do, no? They do. Yes. Actually, a crow. What other bird does a crow look like? A what? Like a raven? Or a magpie? Did you ever see a magpie?
No.
That's what a crow looks like. And you know what a crow likes to do? Pick up shiny things. And hides it. Oh, he's a big hider. Finds things and hides it. Boy. And what?
And he scares
scarecrows. He sits on scarecrows, doesn't he? Yes, a lot of pictures with crows on. That's why they call it scarecrows. Some scarecrows don't work for some crows. Huh? Mm-hmm. Do you ever hear a crow crow?
Yeah.
How's a crow crow?
Yeah.
Try it. Maybe we can get our crow to crow if you do. What do the crows like to eat? Do you know?
No. Corn.
Corn.
Yeah, but mostly nuts. Yeah, nuts and meat. Hello, I thought he took a nut off my finger. How are you?
How about peanuts?
Yes, would like peanuts. You like peanuts?
Yeah.
You like peanuts? Let's go a crow together, see if we can get the crow to crow. Go ahead, crow. Those are your friends, crow. See? That's a lovely bird. What do you like about the crow?
Like when he flies.
When he flies?
Yeah.
What else?
Like when he crows.
When he crows? What do you like about the bird?
When he flies.
You like, how about you?
When he flies over my head.
The color you like, Samika? Yes? Any other thoughts about the birds? Well, you know, there's one thing all animals do, no matter what kind of an animal you are. You have to eat.
Here's the tissue you wanted, Lance. What shape is this side of this box?
Rectangle.
A rectangle. How do we know that? It has two short sides and two long sides. Very good. Hey, we got a
chorus. This will be two Square tool is cut down the middle.
If you cut it in half, that's right. A square has all four sides are
the same
length, right? Well, what about the front of this radio, Paul?
Rectangle.
This part around here is a rectangle.
But that part's a square.
Yeah, that's good. But this big part around here, rectangle, right?
Mm-hmm. So this place.
Anybody see any more rectangles right around in this neighborhood?
Yeah.
The pictures.
Oh, the pictures. Those are good rectangles. Look at this. Beep, 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 beep. Aha! Is that a rectangle?
Yeah.
Right, because it has two long sides and two short sides.
And a rectangle.
And there are little rectangles in it.
Oh, in here. Uh-huh. This is all made up of rectangles, right?
And down the side.
The whole big whatnot show.
Do you know what it says here in the Sesame Street news?
What?
It says it's time to go goodbye. It's time to go goodbye. That's what it says right here. Goodbye. Look, go goodbye.
It does.
So you have to say
goodbye.
Oh, say goodbye.
You don't read
that. Oh, holy words. Look, say goodbye.
Goodbye.
So, would you say goodbye?
Goodbye.
Goodbye. We can't get it together. We're going in the store.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters R and V, and by the number 3. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.